Hello viewers, I'm SB and welcome back to the Curious Expedition. I think this is very promising. I mean, look, two burial mounds, a temple, and two villages. But I am a little concerned about the buried golden pyramid. That does make things a lot more difficult. Both of these have, I don't know, this one also has a buried pyramid. It also has a portal. I don't feel confident doing a portal at all. This has to be right. Two mummies, three shrines. Yeah. Alright, we're going for this. Alright. We did it. We brought the dude home. We got 100 funds. We have so much money. So much money. Yes, I will find and kill this hyena. Absolutely, I will do that for you. Okay, so who do we want to bring on our horrible doomed expedition next? So we have... we have no cannibalism left. We have a sexist, drunk, paranoid guy who will carry a gun with him at all times, so that's fun. And then we have the cook, and all that's wrong with the cook is alcoholism, which at this point makes him look like a shining example of humanity. So the translator increases sanity gain and resting in villages. That is not a valuable skill for this party. We are already great at resting in villages. We are on red green dice, so a blue die would be handy. 4 health, 1 capacity. We get a cultist cultist doesn't work for us at all. Like, this is not valuable. Or we could pick up an artist who carries a blue die and some capacity for increasing our score, which I actually think I really want. Let's go ahead and bring an artist. And we could get a missionary, a Bedouin, or a Scottish soldier. Scottish soldiers increase the sanity gain by drinking whiskey. And whiskey is already, like, the best thing by a huge margin. I don't think we need another red dye, though. Another green dye would be okay. We're not going to an actual desert, so this is a little... this is of dubious value. This, on the other hand, might be really good. I know we're not picking up a lot of carrying capacity, and... honestly, this missionary might get tossed out for a pack animal, but we can indeed utilize a follower of our Lord on our expedition. I know why Lord is I know why the L in Lord is capitalized. Why is the O in our capitalized? that kind of seems like it's implying that, yeah, the we and the Lord, basically same level. Okay, so we don't have a lot of carrying capacity, but remember, we're not actually going to be holding on to all this stuff for very long. Hopefully, we're going to trade these teeth pretty early in the adventure. We can afford to drop the red mushroom if it comes right down to it as well. We do have some alcoholism in the party, so we could go... like, the whiskey's tricky, right? Because it's powerful, and it'll help keep the cook from turning on us and murdering us in the night. But every time you use the stuff, there's a chance of spreading the alcoholism through the party. I like binoculars a lot. I don't like having to devote a whole inventory slot to them, but they're good. It's nice to have extra vision. Honestly, I don't know that we're going to use all of the funds here. What am I doing? We have a campsite already. So we're definitely going to need machetes. Machetes are really valuable. We unfortunately just don't... like, we have a lot of funds and not really that much stuff that's worth buying. I mean, we may as well buy all of the whiskey. Maybe we just bank. It could be the case that we end up, you know, listen, I don't want to alarm anybody, but it could be the case that things go wrong out there. And if they do, it would be nice to have some stuff in the bank for starting up the next expedition. Why don't we try something like this? This is a lot of stuff in the inventory. We don't have to actually carry it all. And like I said, I'm kind of hoping that we'll find a pack animal somewhere. Yeah, deal. We'll leave some of it in the ship. We can come back for stuff. Because remember, we can rest at the ship. We gotta make good use of the ship. Alright. So it seems like on this difficulty, you're just going to have high crew turnover. Let's access ship storage. Let's put this away. What else doesn't actually need to come with us? What is stuff that we could save for later? Honestly, I really want all of this. And we have no carrying capacity because we have no animals. We were three slots over, so putting down the mushroom makes it two. Man, do I need to put down the binoculars until we find a pack animal? As much as I hate that. Yeah, maybe. We don't really need the animal teeth, I guess, if we have the machetes. The machetes are pretty great for trade. They're almost a machete is worth almost as much as an animal tooth. Alright, let's try putting back our stack of animal teeth. If we encounter a beastmaster, we'll reconsider. That feels really bad. I don't want to be caught out there without the... I mean, let's do this instead. Close. Okay. We really need to find a village where we can get a pack animal. Oh, hey, a hut. Alright, so what do we see out here? And in fact, this might be a good time for this tome page of extended vision. Let's really get some stuff here. Alright, let's explore this hut. First of all, cleansing. It would be really cool if we could maybe get rid of some of the alcoholism. Secondly, let's see what he has. Random teleportation is real dangerous. This is the most valuable thing in the entire game, though. Alright, so what does he value? I would kind of expect that he would have a higher value on the valuation on the crystal ball. I actually want to keep this. This is really good. Anything that creates camp points is really powerful. So let's trade in whiskey. A lot of this other stuff would be more valuable to other people in other situations. Trade the binoculars. I'm regretting the binoculars, if you couldn't tell. I think they may end up being traded at some point during this expedition. So we could... Man, 4 whiskey is 80 sanity. That feels pretty bad. Do I wanna... Like, what if we do something like this? Deal. And then we cleanse Harold Jeremiah. And then we ask for cleansing again. And this time we trade, what, that was 40 value we had to put up. So, oh no, just 20. It was 40 because I had a tome page on there. We'll trade 2 of our dynamite. Okay, and cleanse all of the alcoholism. And now we'll hopefully only use the whiskey in times of great need. Okay, and we got some sweet... we get some sweet squirrels out of that. I'm actually really happy with how that went. We have the opportunity to level somebody. I mean, the cook is a pretty good one. Jean-Pierre would be all right as well. We're not spending resources on the nun. But neither one of them have to be leveled up right this second. Treasure pendulum's going nuts. Let's see what people have left at this statue. Ooh. I'm taking it. I know. We'll be okay. So we're just going to go back up to almost full sanity. We got to see a lot of stuff. It's kind of weird, though, that there's a vertical line making the end of the vision that we had. Because shouldn't our vision radius be a circle? Anyway. Let's light it up, and what did we find? Wow. Well, we'll definitely take the can. I mean... Okay, so let's eat all these berries, right? 5 climbing gear is 50 value. We could maybe drop the shovels. Come back to the to the boat if we want to go treasure digging. Do I see any more caves? I do. Debating whether or not I want to drop the torches. Okay, let's drop the shovels for now. We do have shovels back in the boat. I guess we'll go to here. We really need to find a village. Or a stone circle would be cool. Come on, hyenas. You want to path into us. You know you do. You're very curious. Oh, well, this is okay. This is a thing we needed to find. I'll activate that seal. Alright, let us... Yeah. Let's come over here. So we're going to end up at a tremendously negative By the way, look at that. Beautiful. We're going to wind up at tremendously negative standing before we actually even encounter any enemies. So what is going to be the most efficient way to deal damage here? We're actually a little short on dice that do damage directly. So like the red die could theoretically roll dude, or could roll sword, and that would kill one of them. I don't know if there's any way to get damage out of the other dice that's more efficient than using Ripper Leaf to kill one hyena. Okay, we got this and we got the dog. Unfortunately, no way to stop this last hyena. Maybe it'll just whiff. It did not. Okay. Well, if wound gets infected, we have plenty of medical supplies. Plus 30 sanity. Awesome. And then we'll level up cook. And we'll cook this meat. We are at 10 sanity per. This is actually this is turning out to be great. We have to drop stuff again. Well, I mean, let's do this, right? Let's paint the shrine. Try to figure out exactly how many slots we have left over. I'm gonna go ahead and use the climbing gear because I think we're gonna discard it. So there's no sense in making the roll that has a chance to turn out poorly. Yep, black nothingness. I know it's dangerous, but I couldn't help myself. So let's drop this and this and the climbing gear probably. And we still have to drop a ton of stuff, unfortunately. The torches, I think, are going. We're just... Man. We have too much gear. I should use this thing. I should keep this on cooldown at all times, right? Okay. This void thing could be a problem, but remember we have the tome page of targeted teleportation. So the absolute worst case scenario here is that we have to teleport to the ship and run. We are not going to have a situation where we're definitely dead. I hate to drop the machetes, but maybe that's where we are, where we're at here. Okay. Let us make for the desert in great haste. This is probably another shrine or a hot spring, healing spring. We are going to flee from it. Alright, so we just started a mission timer, basically. That void is going to expand until it consumes everything. I mean, it can't expand until it consumes everything, right? It stops somewhere. Otherwise, it would obliterate London. Alright, bird, you want to fight? No, in fact, the bird does not want to fight. Well, let's enter the tomb. Hopefully this mummy wants to fight. Yep. Things no one has ever said before. Gee, I hope this mummy wants to fight. So we're looking for eye on this die, probably. We want man and hand. So let's save a hand. Okay. We'll do eye. Punctuation's powerful. And we'll do a kick. And then we'll just get punched in the face by a mummy. There's not really a lot for it. 3-point bleed is pretty great, though. So he's dead now. Boom. Where are we going to find inventory space for a mummy? I really want to keep the canvases around because now that we have devoted space to a painting collection, it's obviously pretty valuable to us to continue painting. Shoot. We may not need the moonstone. But would it be foolish to throw it away? I think the buried pyramids don't require moonstones. We're going to find out if I'm wrong real quick here. Alright. So we have to make a loop around back to the ship. I think it makes the most sense to go here and then start heading back to the coast and then down. I can't believe we haven't found either of the villages yet. Also, I'm really annoyed by the fact that we're going to travel like one space and then fight this bird. Oh, these birds, plural. I wish I'd kept the dynamite. Alright, we want to keep a man and a man in a hand. Alright, because we want man sword shotgun for our shotgun combo. We want man hand for a kick afterward. Does this have value? No, we want mind after this. Okay. So we didn't roll shotgun at all. That really sucks. Let's kick one of them. Then kick another one. And then we have precise attack. And then we have dog. I'm concerned. We might die. Not rolling shotgun at all sucked. There was one of our dice. They have so many attacks. So we just lost two dice. Which is really bad because we were doing poorly before. Alright. We can no longer get Ripper Leap, so I is the most damaging face left on that blue die. Are you joking? Are we seriously not going to get shotgun again? Okay. We desperately needed that. Right, claws. Precise attack on the remaining bird. I didn't think this was going to be a problem, honestly. Maybe... Oh, come on. Maybe I'm not valuing our dice correctly. I should probably look into that and make sure I'm being sensible with the dice. So I'd really like to see eye. Show me eye. Okay. That's lethal. Yeah, and the natives hate us because we can't find their damn village. Standing minus 8. Ugh. Alright, well, we level Le Mercier. Le Mercier? Le Mercier? I don't know. This is 80 funds. It feels pretty bad to throw that out. Well, there's no reason not to cook and eat 2 meat. Then we need to discard the meat and honestly, maybe the whiskey? Well, hold on. Between a stack of 9 whiskey and a stack of 8 meat, we definitely keep the meat. And the question is, do we also discard the meat? And I think the answer is yes. Everything else in our inventory is really valuable, or at least in the case of the canvases, potentially valuable. How's that void doing? It's getting largish. If it threatens the boat, we'll just teleport back. I should have canceled travel there. Okay, let's enter this village. They hate us here. Oh my god, are you kidding me? The giant chasm, like the line of chasms we saw, isn't the west edge of the map? Well, I think that we're probably not going to get our golden pyramid, because we certainly can't afford to head over here. Well, I guess we can. We don't have to be able to get back, right? Because we have the targeted teleportation. We can just teleport back to the boat. Alright, so we have to put them at ease because of the way things have worked out here. Fortunately, we have these bird feathers. Unfortunately, they don't actually have a lot of things that I care about. Alright, let's give them all of the bird feathers. That'll put us at -2 standing. Shoot, we need to get further. They don't value canvas a lot, but they do value paintings. +9. I need one more point of standing so that we can try to recruit. Although I don't see any animals. I don't suppose we're like really close to standing 10. Nope. Not close enough for 6 value to make up the difference. Man. How about all of this stuff? No. We're going to have to actually give them something. You know what? At this point, let's just trade some of the canvas. Alright, standing +10. There we go. Recruit. A water buffalo. Oh, thank God. Okay, and we rest here. Jean-Michel Guerlain. Hey. Hey, old cook. You've been supplanted by new cook. He had slapped a child. To free him, I would have to make up for his offensive accent. Sorry, buddy. No. Yeah, paint a native. Then we will rest, gain most of our sanity back. get out of here and fire the nun, unfortunately. Oh. Yeah, fire the nun. Sorry. I know. Everybody's mad. Okay, nobody's mad enough to be disobedient. That's my primary concern. Whew, okay, things get way better when we find a village. So I think we... Now that I know that there's a whole thing going on to the west, I kind of want to change my routing. But once we go over there, we can't come back. So I guess I'm going to ignore these. We're going to head west, and then the moment it looks like we're the boat is threatened by the void, we have to teleport to it. Also, I didn't know that this was down here. What is this? This could be a seal. We could be making the pyramid unavailable to us by skipping stuff, too. That's a real concern. And I don't think I have the time to head up here and then come back down. So we kind of have to go for this now if we're going for it at all. So, are we going for it at all? Plus, it's dangerous to travel because we don't have any sanity restoration anymore since it threw away all the whiskey. But, I mean, it gets less dangerous to travel if we get into any fights at all. I'm very torn. This right here is the choice that's going to determine whether or not we can get to the Golden Pyramid. I'm so nervous about making it wrong. Alright, we're going for this. I don't know what's down here, but we gotta... Actually, are we going to get there in time? Oh, it looks like we probably... Yeah, we're probably okay. The void expands fairly slowly. Well, we're taking all this stuff. Oh, come on. Don't get superstitious on me. That's a thing I need not to happen. Come on, hyena. Don't run. Awesome. That is the perfect way for that to have unfolded. Can I mount up? Yes. Okay. I want to throw the water buffalo's die in there because he's actually pretty good. So, this is, I don't use this a lot, but Faint stuns all of the enemies, removing one die from their attack, and all these enemies only have one die. So that just turned off the hyenas for the turn. Alright, I don't think I want to hold sword, because sword's not any good if you don't have eye to pair with it. So I'm hoping this comes back up, man. Great. So first of all, shotgun power blast. Secondly, kick. I guess we'll go ahead and... It doesn't matter. There was literally nothing that green die could have been that would have mattered. Because the hyenas don't get to attack this turn and shield falls off. Alright, horns. The water buffalo has a face that does 4 damage, which is pretty fantastic. Alright, let me eat all this stuff. Hell yeah. We make so much sanity when we fight. Alright, do I have time to run over here, loop around this way, and still get through here? I honestly don't know. The hyena pelts are individually more valuable than animal teeth, but I'm going to drop them because these panthers are going to drop teeth and not pelts, obviously. Really, walking through the thick jungle is better than walking over the sand. Ooh, I did not realize that there was... Goddamn panther. It moved after I clicked cancel travel. That's really annoying. Okay. Let's activate the seal. This should be the last one. Okay, so good. That shows us the location of the thing. Alright, so we have to make a sprint for that, basically. We also have to actually treat that wound. Okay. Do I want to... Yeah, you know what? Let's just go ahead and spend it. So my plan was to fight the hyena... Or the panther, because I didn't realize that it was going to flee from us. It needs to stop running. Okay. We're having a really hard time rolling shotgun when I want to. Alright, so we're going to punctuate this hyena. If we can get the shotgun, things are going to be really good. Do I want to take a 2 damage face? No, I'm going to be greedy. Let's go for something better. I'm not feeling as greedy anymore. Alright, if we don't roll shotgun, this is going to be pretty bad. And of course we didn't. Okay, so... This guy's gonna bleed for three. We have to do 3 damage to him. We may as well do this. Because if we do sword, then shield, shield, it's not as much, it's not as efficient, man. We don't get as much shielding out of it. That shotgun is remarkably inconsistent. Alright, the water buffalo, really putting up. So what do we add here? We're at -2. I'm actually fine with that. So we eat all the meat. We may as well stop by the village on our way past, like here, and take a rest. I think that's the thing we can afford to do. Finest meat I've ever tasted. Okay, it explicitly is named overcooked meat, so. But I guess we appreciate what you're doing for the cook's self-esteem. We maybe don't have time to rest. We certainly don't have time to wait for these volcanoes to stop going off, so I'm really annoyed about the volcano thing. And there's no way through to the north. We'd need 3 dynamite to make a path to the north, plus it would be so much longer that the ship might not still be around by the time we got there. We're looking at 23 days of travel. Alright, I'm gonna drop the panther pelt, and... Jesus. Okay, we actually don't have a choice. We have to stop at the village. But I'm a little concerned that we're not going to have time to make it through this narrow gap. None of these are gonna be helpful, right? Yeah, a waterfall would allow us to gain some sanity back, but it would do it at the cost of 1 million days, what we just don't have. Let's rest. Party's all male, right? Okay, I'm gonna be diplomatic, and regardless of the woman called me an ignorant buffoon and strode away. Sorry, lady. I will not hand over the mummy. Then I will sleep, and then we will run. The villagers are mad. So it seems like time maybe doesn't actually pass. This space needs to not be in the void. Shoot. No, we can't make it anymore. Right? There's no way through. Yeah, the void has eaten all the land to the south. And there's no sense in not going. You know, you're just going to have to eat the sanity cost. Stop trying to veer south. I guess this is a real path. I wish that the guy had a second tome page of teleportation. Or maybe a tome page of stopping time or something. Alright, if any part of our path disappears, we have to cancel travel. This is very risky. Any of these tiles could disappear at any moment. I think we may just have to bail. We're going to lose out on a lot of points. Shoot, man. Yeah, I'm not happy about this at all. We did manage to find a reasonable amount of fame worth of stuff. Yeah, we can't go on. We can't go on. So I'm going to target a teleportation back to here, maybe? Let's see here. 154. From here to the boat is actually only about 40 sanity. So yeah, we can... No, cancel. Hey. I wish it wouldn't do that. I hate the fact that it reads mouse up as clicking a button, even if you didn't mouse down on the button. Because I was just trying to drag the camera around. But now we lost a bunch of sanity. Alright, I'm gonna target a teleportation to here. Okay. Because this way, we can at least get this and this on the way out. So let's enter the village. These guys are pretty mad at us. Let's see if we can maybe trade something with them. So that's a good thing to have. We already have a stack of those going. Is there a point to holding onto these animal teeth? We already have a full stack of animal teeth at the boat. This would get us back to them not wanting to kill me. And then we can rest here. Ugh. Refuse to hand over the mummy. There goes all my standing. Paint a native. Sleep. How many green dice do we have? We have 1 week. 2, 3 week. I'm gonna go, we're gonna steal the idol. They already hate us, you know, whatever. Okay, sure, we'll barter something to them. Well, I actually really don't have anything that I want to barter to them. Are we wounded still? We have 1 wound, 2 wounds, but they're both almost healed. They probably won't get infected. The problem is we don't have a lot of things that we're not planning to use. Alright. Tome Page of Extended Vision, I think, is actually less good than Tome Page of Waterfall Creation. This could save our lives. This will just be, like, pleasant. Alright, deal. Men in Europe have one wife. They also steal your important religious idols, suckers! Okay. And now, the fleeing. A velociraptor is about to be consumed by the void. Okay, this is kind of what I thought. So let's paint the shrine, opening up an inventory space and putting another painting in our collection. Then we enter the shrine, we steal this, and we bail. Okay, I'm not entirely happy with that, but as far as expeditions that didn't make it to the pyramid go, I think this was a pretty good one. Alright, let's sail home, not victoriously. I reflected on the values of my father. Did I really want to abort this expedition? Are we writing to our father? I reflected on the values, my father. Or did they forget to write the rest of the sentence? We better abort. The whole place is about to become an inky void. Let's get out of here. So, you lose a lot of fame when you don't hit the Golden Pyramid. This would be a lot better if it wasn't about to be the sixth expedition, where we're almost certainly only going to see one village. Navigator's not bad. Well, Navigator's kind of bad. Our compass gains accuracy so slowly that I haven't been using it. We're just hitting everything and revealing the pyramid that way. So you know what? I'm going to take Climber. Because I think Navigator's not going to improve the accuracy gain enough for it to matter. Okay, we're down by only like 250. That's not so bad. We definitely have enough funds that we can afford to gift everything that's worth fame. Okay, 40 fame worth of paintings. That's not so bad. There's no point in doing these now. We'll hold on to the stack of teeth. And we'll trade it for fame afterward. Oh, I did not. Sorry. Did not, in fact, kill Snarfrattle. I forgot. Should we accept this quest? Can we afford to fail it, is my question. You know what? We're going to try it. We're going to find the deserter. We're going to kill him. And I'm actually pretty happy with our party. I think we're good. So no thanks. And no thanks. But I do want to say that I think that the double recruit perk has been very valuable. I'm not at all sad that we took it. Okay, so remember, we don't actually need a lot of stuff here. Okay, I'll take the pistol. The pistol's the worst gun, but it combos with green dice, which we have a bunch of. And, I mean, the worst gun is still a gun. Actually, at this point, it doesn't matter if people become alcoholics. That's maybe a cold way to put it, but I think we can afford to bring whiskey. Now, if we save 150 funds, we can do double saddle upgrade, but maybe we don't want to be that frugal. Yeah, I'm not going to be that frugal. Let's save 50 funds. We'll buy one saddle upgrade. Let's do this. Weather balloons are really good. Yeah, maybe something a little more like this. Honestly, weather balloons are really good. So is dynamite. Okay, this is what I'm gonna do. Deal. And plus one capacity. So we're at exactly our carrying capacity, but we're gonna, I think, use the weather balloons as soon as we get into the mission. Whew, all right, let's get out there. We might be able to do this. The scoring's a little tight. We definitely have to get the Golden Pyramid if we want to win, I think. Either that or we have to have just an incredible run. All right. Do I want to dump anything in ship storage? Actually, you know what? I probably can. We only have one first aid kit, though. I should have bought more first aid. Well, at this point, leaving something in ship storage is not significantly different than just throwing it away, because we're probably not ever coming back for it. Let's just get out of here. All right, so I'm gonna send up the weather balloons right now. Let's get as much information as we can right at the beginning. Okay, so we know where a camp point is. That's really cool. We know where the village is. That's really cool. Oh my god, we didn't buy any canvases. This painter is a lot less useful without a canvas. All right, I feel dumb. To be perfectly honest, that might mean that we're okay trading out the painter for a dinosaur that has higher carrying capacity. Conrad, you're coming with us. He assured us that he would not be coming with us. That's the opposite of what I just said. All right, let's see here. What is my plan? It would be really cool if we could get Ripper Leap on him, so I'm gonna hold that. I'm gonna hold one man. I think we may as well just spend the claws, right? Alright, so I'm gonna hold this in hopes of Ripper Leap. I'm gonna hold this looking for a shotgun to match it with. And then I think I'd actually rather have these be sword. One of them can be man, and we can try to get like a lot of hands. All of a sudden I'm sure that we're not going to get there. You mess with the guy who owns the water buffalo, apparently you get the horns. He has three dice. I don't know if we headbutt him, which one will be lost. I don't know if there is a way to know. We could pop the dynamite out and use it in conjunction with the mind to not take any personal damage. But let's call that plan B. I'm very torn about what I want to do here. Okay, so we didn't roll shotgun again because the shotgun is the least useful gun in the history of time. But we did get Ripper Leap, which kills him. Right? Yeah, he's dead now. Alright, 30 free sanity, some free standing. Let us trade with the villagers and get their. Oh, hey, raw meat. That's pretty valuable to us. What else is valuable to us? Honestly, this red mushroom might be important. I think we have to take that. This is just 10 or 15 sanity. I don't know that we need to trade for that. We're gonna have enough trouble putting together value for just this stuff. Actually, never mind. The natives love whiskey. Okay, deal. Since we're at positive standing now, we could recruit a dinosaur. Do I want a Parasaurolophus over Jean-Pierre Lemessurier, or do I hope against hope that we somehow find an abandoned trek that has some canvas in it? I mean, his blue dye is useful. But you know what else is useful? Carrying capacity. If I dismiss him, everybody's gonna get all mad. We'll keep him, we'll keep him. We will. I guess just leave. We're cool, right? Yeah, everything's cool. I'm double checking in my head. I'm like, did we do everything you need to do? So, we need more information. We're not ready yet. Let's have a look over here. What do we got? Zombie pygmies are not a problem at all. The zombie pygmy fight is a fight against a lot of small, weak enemies, and the shotgun is like tailor-made for this. In fact, let's plan on going over there. This will make this trip very low sanity cost. I mean, provided we actually roll a shotgun, because it's looking like that's a thing that's actually quite rare. So we'll hold all of these. We'll hold a hand. Okay, we finally rolled shotgun. So let's put back all these very useful dice. Start with Power Blast. And then the... There we go. We're very reliant on that shotgun actually coming up, which is a little scary. There's no good reason for us not to take this. Okay, that's interesting. And then, so we know we don't really need teeth for anything, but this is at least 40 fame, a big stack of teeth. It's possible that I should have gone back to the ship and dropped it off while I was still down here. Whatever. Whatever, man. I don't need no spear. We're gonna need that spear at some point, I'm sure. I'm gonna feel really bad. Let's upgrade the cook, I guess? I mean, yeah, let's upgrade the cook. And then we'll drop... Do I want to drop the whiskey? Is that a good idea? I kind of want to drop the shovels. Honestly, I like it. The odds of us finding something with the treasure pendulum are low enough that I'm wondering if the shovels are maybe not the better play here. Because now this is 60 sanity. I'm going to drop the torches. I'm going to hold on to both of the sanity things. Something tells me we may need them. I'm okay not going into that cave. Come on. Annoyed. The water started receding. Like one tick too late for us to make it through here quickly. Okay, this is a good thing to find quickly. I am, at this point, just going to cook and eat all the meat. So good. So good. Alright, let's head over here. We still don't really want to fight raptors. Like, we're good fighters, but raptors are dangerous. Structure showed big cracks. I'm okay with that. Big cracks are fine. We don't need the moonstone, because it's a buried pyramid. We need some mountains erupting from the ground. Hopefully that won't change things for us too much. We do have a little bit of emergency dynamite if needed. Alright, and then we have too much stuff. Can you believe it? Too much stuff. How could this happen? Alright, we really need like every fame-generating thing we can get. Because like I said, I'm a little nervous about our score. Yeah, sure. Let's search the area. Some old equipment. Okay. Toss the ropes. But do I want to keep the machetes? Because the machetes are actually pretty good. We're traveling through a lot of forest and jungle, and the machetes really help. Is there something I like less than I like these machetes? Maybe we drop the campsite? We're never using it. I hate that idea, but... I may be over-preparing with our ability to fight and our ability to drink whiskey. That's an important ability. I'm going to drop the first aid kit. I know that sounds crazy. But it is only one wound heal, and it's taking up a whole slot. Let's see what's over here. We have the machetes to make this a reasonable trip. Okay, so there's a million caves everywhere. Because, of course, that would have to be the case if we are going to drop our torches. Yep, everybody becomes an alcoholic, but at this point, I don't think it can matter anymore. I think it's too late for us to worry about that. This is the roof of the world. I don't think we need to go up here. Let us, instead, get some vision. Okay, what do we got here? So we have a lot more caves. We have some other stuff. Let's explore all the other stuff. Great. There's going to be three of these. So we need to find one more. I think we have to find either the pyramid or the third seal pretty soon. Unless this area is a lot larger than I think it is. Let's search this. Found some old equipment. Hey, look at that. We found some canvases. We also found some raptors. I'm going to drink the rest of the whiskey. And we're going to head down into the left toward this waterfall. Our goal is the waterfall. I'm glad I didn't throw out any of the sanity generators. Okay, so if we can get this to come up mined, we actually might want to use the dynamite. Found a little extra. We hold sword and we don't take this because it's better if it comes up I. It's at least equally as good if it comes up I. Yeah, so we hold gun, we reroll that, we reroll this because it would be better for it to be mined, but if it stays I, that's okay because we'll pair it with the sword. Alright, keep hand, pull again. Okay, so we got I to go with our sword. This guy is going to bleed for 3 at the beginning of his turn. We need to put 1 more damage on him. Or 3 more damage on him, sorry. And then, we just eat the other attack. Ow. Beak hurts. Beak is big. Just completely obliterated our water buffalo. That's harsh. I think we're cool with all of these. And that. Really like to roll some guns. Okay. So we want to do shotgun blast, the point blank shotgun blast. Follow it with punctuation. And then you need 1 more damage, which we have. Okay. Loot. Awesome. Those bird feathers are worth 10 fame each. That's nice. And we found some canvases. So let's cook all the meat. Eat some of the meat. Move to here. Examine shrine. Paint shrine. Enter shrine. Investigate altar. Take fancy stuff. Lose standing. Not trigger the curse. Lucky day. And then have to drop a bunch of stuff. Cool. What is looking like it might not be useful? Oh, we should also be using this. Let's do it here. Okay, we didn't get a lot of useful information. I've definitely not been using my crystal ball as often as I need to. So, what is least useful? We could just use the red mushrooms and hope that we don't take any more big wounds. That seems a little optimistic, though, especially as we know that there are raptors everywhere. And we might need to fight them for sanity. I guess we could camp for sanity. And we have lots of food. Let's just use these. Okay. The water buffalo has become paranoid. And the cook has become afraid of butterflies. I'm not sure what impact the water buffalo being terrified is going to have on us, but I'm sure that the butterfly thing is not going to come up. Seems unlikely. So let's head this way. We can go through some zombie pygmies. I feel pretty confident about that. Oh, we have to drop another thing before I do that. The pistol has not been very fun. Do I drop... These things all give fame. We need that. This thing can become fame. These all give fame. So basically, it's like, do I drop a gun or the dynamite? Or do I drop this canvas, assuming that we won't have another use for it? At the very least, we have to go back to the boat, right? And the native village isn't far from the boat, and it would allow us to refill. So we'll probably go back to the native village, and there we can use the canvas, if nowhere else. I can't imagine it's right to drop the meat at this juncture. Maybe the dynamite. Maybe the pistol. The pistol's pretty bad, as far as weapons go. Pistol's pretty crummy. It does, in theory, allow you to get a hand-to-hand pistol for like a 6 damage headshot, which is nice. It's hard to turn a green die into 2 damage. I'm very torn. Very, very torn. I'm gonna go ahead and drop the pistol, I think. Right, the pistol is the least useful of our non-fame-giving supplies, I think, as crazy as that sounds. On account of it being a gun and everything. Please stop running. Okay, let us fight. Once again, this is going to be really great if we roll shotgun and really bad if we don't. Do I want to keep... I'm going to throw this one back. So here we have Sword Eye for 3 damage. Adding Eye to it increases the damage by a lot, but we don't actually need to increase the damage by a lot against these enemies. So I'm going to try to roll Mind to make these extra hands really powerful. I'll take that Eye. And I did get Mind. Oh, okay, we got Shotgun, so this is over. We do this. Kabam. And then this. Easy. I already know how easy it is. Let's, we're gonna throw out the blue mushrooms, so we may as well pop one. Area's a little smaller than I thought. Let's do some coca tea. Sounds great. Toss extra blue mushroom, toss red mushroom? Is that a sensible thing to do? Not really, but I'm doing it. Starting to become a little concerned. Are you guys becoming a little concerned? That there doesn't seem to be anything down here? We actually have to come down here to find out, though. Take advantage of the camp point. Oh, we'll do a landscape painting. Cool. And then we will rest overnight. While huddled around the campfire, we heard what sounded like a fight coming from nearby. A young native was striving to fend off a wild creature. Well, we'll definitely help him. Oh dear, tigers. This is maybe a little bit more than I bargained for. Keep eyes useful? Is eye better than mind with this? Yeah, I think it is, because we can try to get punctuation off. Alright, we're looking to roll a sword on any of our red dice. We did not find it. Here we have Ripper Leap into punctuation. We really need swords, like badly. Okay. What am I doing? So let's actually start firing stuff off here. We have a lot of damage, so we have Ripper Leap available. This guy needs 3 damage. Well, that's unfortunate. Because we don't have anything to do with the rest of our dice then. Ow. Okay, that hurts. But this guy is, I mean, obviously a single tiger is not much of a match for us. We kind of rolled horrible dice, though. We can headbutt him twice. Does that stack? Actually, I've never done that before. Well, we'll find out. Keep this, try to roll sword. Okay, I guess we won't find out. Never mind. Alright, so this rest will take us to 100, thanks to the fighting. We will cook that meat. Leave. Okay, Jean-Pierre Lemercier is starting fires for no reason. And we have too many Trek members. Sorry, dude. I'm a little bummed that we didn't get any standing from doing that. I don't really want to fight people a lot. Alright, so let's finish cooking this and then drop... These are worth 5 fame each. I mean, it might be time to drop the campsite. Like, I know that sounds crazy, but we have... What is this? 180 sanity worth of animal meat? Plus the ability to create a waterfall in a, you know, semi-random location. I don't want to drop the crystal ball. We're going to need it, I think. And everything else either gives fame or sanity. I guess we still could drop the dynamite. Yeah, alright. That seems sensible. Alright, so I think if we get to this hilltop, it should reveal everything else that's down here. The alcoholism's starting to kick in. Okay, there is in fact nothing else down here. Well, let's head back to the waterfall and we'll rest there again. Ah, Gerard Champney has become obsessed with wealth and valuables, and now he's a kleptomaniac. That's actually really bad, because that means he can steal things from us that are worth fame. He might reduce our score. Alright, so we'll go back to full, and then I guess we just have to range north. We have to find either the pyramid or the third seal, and then that'll tell us what we need to know to finish this up. So I guess we just kind of. Oh, hey, we have our crystal ball. Okay, it looks like there's nothing up here. Shoot. Well, I guess it must be. How can there be nothing up here? You know what? We're gonna go fight raptors. This is how we're gonna check. Make sure that there's nothing up here. Alright. Yeah, there's nothing up here. Okay, so we keep this for Ripper Leap. This is for Shotgun. We want Sword on this die then, and Eye on this die. Actually, let's keep the weak blue die, because this die will definitely be something, no matter what we roll. No matter how many times we re-roll it. Alright, this is going to be pretty scary. We're going to take a lot of damage here. Oh, wait. Hold you for Ripper Leap. Hold you guys for stuff. We want Eye, Hand, Hand, some. I don't know. Okay, that's terrible. So this is 3 damage, this is 2 damage, 2 shield. But we have literally no other use for an Eye, right? Well, we could stun them all. Because we're actually not going to kill any of them, Jesus. So this does remove 3 attack dice. Right, yeah, we can only do 3 more damage this turn, so it's not, we don't have lethal on anybody. And then 3 points of shielding and 1 point of damage. Oh my god, that was terrible. We rolled really, really badly there. Alright, well. All of the dice that weren't stunned rolled faces. Pretty unlikely. We're having some bad bees. We have exposed ourselves to the RNG. And it's not like this is completely unexpected. So we're going to hold out for Ripper Leap again. Because we need it. Like, it has to happen or we're not going to win. Okay. You know, if you only have one out, you have to play to it. That's, So Ripper Leap is lethal. Well, hold on. We actually lead with Shotgun Power Blast. That puts everybody at low health. We kill one of them with this. We kill another one with Ripper Leap. And we just have to eat the third one, unfortunately. Well, blanks. Yeah, he rolled a blank. That's about what we expect, right? His face, yeah. That's a little better. You know what? When I was complaining about the number of blanks, I thought they had 2 blanks on their die. Quick shot. Okay, this stuff is valuable, right? I think we can only have 20 meat in a stack. That's fine. We can eat this meat right now. These are 20 fame each. We have to keep these. Is this where I am finally discarding the campsite? It feels pretty bad, but we have so much meat. And there's still so many things to fight. I'm really worried about the wounds, though. Yeah. Campsite. We're so injured. We are so injured. I want to step over here just to make sure that there's nothing in this space, because we're starting to run out of places where things can actually be. We're not going to explore the cave because we have very few. Well, we have significantly better than a 50% chance of succeeding on a cave roll. And we can't get much more injured than we are now, although we could have somebody replaced by an abomination. I had that happen once. Because we have a 50% die and then 2 33% dice to roll the eye. I don't feel comfortable. Let's just not test it. Eat some more meat, and then we have to investigate over here. This is the only place where stuff could still be. There's not really that much room for question marks unless there's a path that goes somewhere that we have missed. Okay, you know what would be really cool? If this was the seal. Oh! I'm also 100% fine with this. This is actually really good for us. Because this heals our wounds magically. Through the magic of healing springs. Alright, we're not going to rest again. We're going to keep moving. We have enough meat to keep us insanity. I just wanted the heal. Alright. The Golden Pyramid must be around here somewhere. In addition, the remaining seal must be around here somewhere. Okay, we found some stuff I don't care for. I don't know why I even took it. I knew I was going to throw it away. This is probably the pyramid, right? Yeah, okay. So let's see where that last seal is. Alright, it's a bit of a trek, but there's a pretty obvious path into the area. Maybe there is? Actually, I think we want to go north, it looks like. Okay. Let's eat a little meat and get ready to fight a velociraptor, a Utah raptor, probably. It's dangerous. There's three of them. Okay, so obviously we open with shotgun power blast. Then we keep this looking for ripper leap, we keep this looking for punctuation. We get both. Awesome. This is much better than last time. So this guy's, oh, not dead. This is 7 damage. 7 damage before the enemy turn. So this guy will have to endure one turn of hits from. But he'll bleed to death at the beginning of his next turn. Wow, that's really lucky. Oh no, it's just 2 blanks. But still, that's actually pretty lucky. So he's dead already. We just need to get this guy. So we'll keep all of these. We'll keep all of these. Okay. Alright, I think gun seals it, right? Because we get to point blank him and then we get to double attack him. Okay. Now the other raptor bleeds to death. Take all this stuff. And then we have too many items again. Huh. Well, at this point, maybe it's the extra slot of food. Oh, we don't have to guess. Let's see if there is in fact a path through the north. So we could go back to the spring. Just because I'm worried about the infected wounds, I'm worried about wounds getting infected. These guys are pretty hurt. It'll take a long time for them to heal, naturally. So what are we dropping? The teeth are worth fame. But almost everything in our inventory is worth fame at this point. I'm going to drop this. Because I don't think we're going to need it anymore. I think we're done searching for stuff, right? We just get to the seal, come back, get to the pyramid, and then leave. So we're going to stay at the springs one time. Hooray! We don't usually sleep places at high sanity because I'm trying to use it to restore our sanity most optimally. So it's kind of nice to just get all these positive events. Alright. So we need to do this. And then once we're there, we eat a little bit of meat, head back. We're starting to get some anger. All we have to do is get out of here. Okay, cancel travel. Oh no, everything's fine actually. Come on, space burnout. Yeah, good. Activate the seal. Awesome. Let's eat meat until we're basically back at full. Do I want to go for this? Who knows what it could be? But maybe I'm that's pushing it. Everybody's angry. Let's just get out of here. Let's just plan to leave. We have enough meat to keep sanity high, but everybody's angry. I'm not sure like what might happen. We're definitely going to want to try to keep sanity high. I don't want an event sparking and then everybody killing each other. Turns out alcoholism does come back to bite you in the ass. Who would have thought? Okay. Meet. So there are villagers after us now, because we've been at negative 10 standing for quite some time. We got to get back to the ship somehow. It's the furthest away. Alright, how far can we travel without running out of sanity? Down to here? It's going to take us through some angry villagers. Let's zoom out a little bit. So I think this might be a more reasonable path. Yeah, and then straight south from here. So let's plan on this. Let's see, we're probably going to end up having to fight some villagers. I don't think we're going to be able to run from all of them. Oh, maybe, actually. Yeah, we might be just fine. And I'm starting to feel really confident because we apparently are going to get home last, which is frustrating. But we have a lot of fame in our bag here. And we managed to not even lose anybody on this last expedition, which is like a brand new record. Uh-oh. I sat at the night fire after a tiring day when Jean-Pierre Le Mercier loomed over me. I was ready for yet another rattling of sabers, but instead he offered peace. After consideration, he now related better to some of the hard decisions I had to make and was willing to accept my superiority. Oh, nice, so he lost his angry state. If I hit attack, is it going to fight the villagers, the angry lizard people, or the... Also, angered for negative 28 days, I think you should be leaving me alone. Okay, this is going to be hard. We're going to get our asses kicked a little bit here, I think. I'm making a lot of the same decisions over and over again in battle, so I apologize if I'm not describing everything again. But this time we got Ripper Leap, and we got Punctuation, which is great. And roll again, and maybe... Nope, it doesn't come up shield. Okay, that's fine. A single point of shielding wasn't going to be that bad. And at this point, our wounds are largely irrelevant. I don't think that we're going to have time for anybody to get infected before we get back to the boat. The wounds are only relevant insofar as they cause us to lose dice in combat. Okay, and then we have Precise Attack to finish things, and that's awesome because now we get even more fame. Oh, we slightly went over into another stack of teeth. I'm going to toss the meat at this point. All right, run. Don't fight the villagers. Okay. Actually, fighting the villagers might not be such a bad idea. No, I don't think we'll get... lizard people. Maybe they give us hides. Let's fight them. You know what? I'm being stupid. Let's... I don't know how many villagers that is. It could be a horrifying number. We could lose that fight and lose the whole game right here. Let's just return to the ship, sail home victoriously. Endless fame awaits. Well, we'll see. I'm feeling pretty good. We didn't get any placement. Oh, we did. We weren't last. Okay, 24-68 with what we have in our bag. I do feel like this is probably going to be a win. Triumph. This is wonderful. Yeah, that's not enough of a lead. Awesome. Well, guys, I think we did it. We gift everything, because there's no point in doing anything else. Paintings got up to 25 fame each. That's pretty great. And there we go. That's another... It's going to be a second here. That's another win for us on Certain Death. We're definitely figuring this out. I have to say, the game is way more compelling on Certain Death in the sense that I really feel like failure is around the corner on every single run, so it feels really good to win. All right, we did it. And this time we even brought home more than just ourselves. Once he had secured his legacy with the splendid statue, he enjoyed a happy life in the knowledge that history would hold him without measure. Without measure! We even managed to keep Luis alive this time. He probably won't get a story. Sergeant Harold Jeremiah returned home and lived off the money of a rich spouse he married shortly after. Nice. Although functioning in society in a rudimentary fashion, he found it impossible to develop new friendships. During his late life, he became obsessed with haunting dreams about a hidden seventh expedition. He was not seen or heard from again. Ooh, is that a hint? Am I being hinted? Oh man, I sure hope that that's a real thing. Now I'm going to be haunted by dreams of a hidden seventh expedition. Gerard Champney returned home and lived off the money of a rich spouse he married shortly after. Good work, everybody. He was plagued by endless nightmares about the inexplicable things he had seen. Even through all the adventures, he never succumbed to his fear of butterflies. His life had been cut short by a tragic accident while hiking. He was so inhibited by the phobia that he became confused and plunged off a cliff. Wow. Lepidopterophobia turns out to have serious consequences. After returning, Jean-Pierre Le Mercier visited many Western countries, setting up exhibitions about those famous journeys. He was knighted by the Queen and wore his new title with great pride. He lived a long, humble life and died in the presence of his faithful pet. Okay, that was even mostly happy endings. Sort of happy endings. Except for the guy who plunged off the cliff. Anyway, that's going to be it for this episode. Good stuff. That's going to be it for this episode of whatever the heck this game is called. Check that out. This could be it for this episode of The Curious Expedition. Come back next time. We're rolling the dice. We're starting a new adventure. And you know what? I might go back and get platinum frames for all these guys. We'll see. Maybe not. Anyway, come back next time. New stuff. We'll see you then.